Hello friends, last time we saw the theory part of some basic string manipulations and today we are going to see the practicals of string manipulations. So very first part we'll see about for vectors. Let me define a vector which has four entries into it, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll check class of x and it will be of type numeric. Now if I define x of 5 equals to a and again check class of x, it will be of type character. So this was the point that we were discussing in the theoretical part, that if you find a single entry that is of type string, entire vector will be coerced to the type string. Now let's see for the matrices. Let me define a matrix y equals to matrix which has two rows and three columns. The very first row will have data points, so you can give this by first row will have data points as a vectors 2, 5 and 7 and y 2. That is, the second row will have the data as a in the form of vectors as a, b and c. I give enter and I'll see how y looks. So it is, you can see, even though the first entry we had inserted as numeric, they had been converted into type character. So you need to always take care while handling matrices and vectors. But this is not the case with data frames. Let's check it out for data frames. Z is a data frame that you define by the function data.frame and you say numbers equals to 1 to 5 and you say letters equals to letters 1 to 5. So I'll give control enter. So you can see Z, well, we'll see the structure of Z. You can see it is a data frame, 5 observations, 2 variables. The first column numbers, it has 5 numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the second, that is letters, has 5 levels A, B, C, D. Let's view it and you can see this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 A, B, C, D, E. The first column, which is having numbers, isn't affected by the character types of column named letters. So this is the way you deal with the data frames. Now, one of the important points you need to know is whenever there is a character vector and you define a data frame, then that character will be converted into type factor by default. So you can change it by mentioning strings as vectors equals to false. There's one more parameter for data frame and you see a structure, you will now see the character and here the factor. The difference, if I insert a parameter strings as vectors equals to false, however the view of a data frame won't change. So this was about data frame. Now let's see there is impact of a strings on lists. Now let's say m is vector and it is of type numeric, n is another vector which has a type character a, b and c. And let me say O is another vector of type logical, T, F, T. So there is an error here. I'll say M to be a numeric vector 1, 2, 3 and a character vector A, B, C and O as a logical vector which has true, false, true and false. Let me define a list named as LST and list m comma n comma o and give enter. Let's check it out, how does this list look like. So you can see that first entry as 1 2 3, second entry as a, b, c and third as true, false, true, false. Now let's check it out, class, and it's a list, class of first element of a list, that will also be a list. But if I say, if I give double braces, it will be of type numeric. So the first entry was numeric, second was character, but the first entry isn't affected by the second entry, and that was character. So we come to a conclusion that if there is a single entry of a string or a character in a vector or a matrix, then all the entries will be coerced to the type character. But this is not the case for data frames and lists. So this was all about practicals of string manipulations in R, and the next topic will be the set operations. How can two sets of string vectors be manipulated?